Hey guys, I would like to remind you, you are watching Captain German Exploring YouTube channel. What does it mean? It means you will learn something really important for your sailing experience. So today, you see, I have a perfect hardtop. I'm staying on this hardtop and I can put 2.5 kilowatt of solar panels, which now install it only 1.1. So it's a huge solar panels and huge energy you can install on your hardtop. And the most important, you will throw away all that fabric shit from your boat. Are you ready? Let's do it. Bimini tent, spray hood, what is sunbrella? Look. This material, which is waterproof, UV resistant, should be perfect, but it lasts for 3 years, 4 years, if we speak about a really hard climate. Hard, I mean, UV level is extremely high. So in this case, your sunbrella fabric will work for you for years, and after you need to change it. So for my boat Beneteau Oceanis, only spray hood cost $2,800, which on my point of view absolutely ridiculous price. So if we speak about all this area, it is a 17 square meters. So it means we are speaking about 7k for spray hood and our roof. So it is a crazy amount of money, and you have to pay it every 4 years. So we decide to make hardtop, which you can do, you can even pay more, but you do it once and it lasts forever. So are you ready? Take popcorn, fill your glass with a beer or wine, and let's go ahead.
The most important part of our project is to make all the measurements properly, because if we make mistake, it will affect all the construction of our hardtop in the future. Removing old parts from our Bimini tent and our spray hood, the parts we will not use in the future, so we need just to take it out. Second step, we need to take out our boom trawler. We need to take out all the blocks, remove all the lines, and put a boom on the side, because we need to have a clear access to our arc from all the sides. And we need to clean a silicone on top of our arc to make it perfectly clean.
Так, какие у нас возможные проблемы могут быть в будущем? Когда мы положим крышку сверху, как определить, где прорезать дырки? Мы сейчас делаем шаблон.
Центр мы определим легко. И вот, вот так вот, это все ложится сверху на арку. И мы будем просто сверлить отверстие там, где у нас крестики. Для того, чтобы арку закрепить вместе с хардтопом.
Now we need to remove old arc and all the parts which holding solar panels on top. So we need to unscrew the frame from the top of our arc and throw away this part and throw away old solar panels, because we can get from our old solar panels only 13 amps, which means our solar panels absolutely not in a proper condition. So we need to change it with a new one. We already found a two good one, 550 panels each, which is a modern one and very efficient, so we will use it instead of our old one. Now we need to come to marina and cut all extra parts. It is more convenient to do it from a shore, because when you stay on anchor, it's not really convenient to work with electric instruments, and it is much more convenient if we stay in marina. Marina gave us overnight stay in a technical zone, so we can come and use all electric instruments and just remove all the parts we are not using, because in the closest future it is a time to check our hardtop, which is almost ready, so we should be prepared for this task. And it is a quite big job we are planning to do right now. All fiberglass jobs will be made by a fiberglass guy from company Ocean Builders. They are producing houses which is staying on the water, so they are very professional in fiberglass. And we hire three guys from this company, and they are planning to do our hardtop really in a good level. I think we will not be able to do it in this level by ourselves, because it's a really big knowledge you should have to do this job. First layer is a gel coat. So they will put this gel coat on a surface which is extremely well polished, and we get shiny gel coat surface. On top of gel coat we will put a fiberglass mat, and after on top of fiberglass we will put a honeycomb to make the structure really strong. One side we have a polished surface, on another side it is a fiberglass mat. And now the guys combine it all the parts together, and we are making drawing on top. So now it is a very important part, because if we cut it wrong, all our hardtop will be wrong. So we need to double check everything, even check it three times before cut. Now we start working with the hardtop shape. So we need to bend it a little bit and put some enforcers inside, because we want to have a small garage to keep our surfboard inside of hardtop. And in another part we need to have it quite strong and have an ability to walk on it. So we need to make the structure really really strong, and another hand to have some space inside. So it is just quite tricky task for guys, but they are professional workers, they are professional in fiberglass, and I think they will be able to do it absolutely correct.
But it's definitely gonna be about the weight of four people.
It's fine. Inside of side wings and the front part, we used a honeycomb inside. So between the layers of fiberglass, we use a honeycomb to make the structure really strong. Now we are going to marina. We will stay in a technical zone, because we are waiting for telehandler. Telehandler will come with our hardtop, and we put it on top of our boat and make all the measurements. Maybe they need to correct the hardtop, maybe we need to cut something on our boat. So that's it, our telehandler coming.
No, aquí, uno, dos, tres, yo corto todos, ¿sí?
Now you can see our construction, our metal frame is much higher than we expected. So we need to cut it and to make adjustment and to put our hardtop straight. And now we are thinking how to do it more easy. In our boat we have a swept back rigging. It means all the shrouds, all the side shrouds stay a little bit in the back of mast. So if we remove back stays, our mast will stay, don't worry. Now cutting metal frames, we used it before for our solar panels. I think our construction will be quite strong. We just use the vertical parts, but horizontal bars we cut away. Also, we have to cut all the tubes we used for the Bimini, because it was a part of a fabric construction just to keep a shape. Our cockpit is almost ready for a hardtop installation. You see just vertical tubes, all new solar panels waiting for installation, and all the tubes which we have we put on the front of boat. So now the construction of hardtop is ready. With a telehandler our hardtop come to our boat. Our boat is ready for installation. So now it is a quite important time. We just put our hardtop on top of our boat and starting all the adjustments, because we need to put it in a correct way. We have to put our hardtop exactly in a position we measure in the beginning, otherwise it will not fit. The tubes which I cut were much higher than we required to, so now we need to cut it, and I hope all the measurements will be still okay. For the present time, for today, we welded only these washers on the bottom and just to put our lid on top of these washers. Tomorrow we will make adjustment and install it in all exactly position we measure in the beginning. Enough for today. Our guys finished their job very late, so you can see now it is dark. What we have now? Our lid just put on top of the washers on a vertical bars. And we need to take ropes and fix our lid on top of the construction and prevent movement. Today is a big day. Our welder prepared the washers which we put from a bottom and to a top of our construction and to screw it together and fixing our hardtop on our boat. So today we will have a lot of welding, and I hope today we will fix all the construction on top of our boat. Do you remember in the beginning I made a template, so cardboard with a drawing of our arc holes. So now we need to adjust our hardtop. We need to find the center of our hardtop and find the center of our arc, and to find the place where we have to drill the holes and screw our hardtop with our arc together, and our bolts should fit exactly in the same place as we expected in the beginning. In Panama we have a delivery service. We buy stuff in Amazon, and with a special delivery service with an affordable price, we can get it straight in the Linton Bay.
Thank you very much.
Our boat made with metric bolts. Unfortunately, here we cannot buy metric, so we have to use inches. I connected bottom and top parts together. I could not find the nuts like this one, so we are using a regular one, but maybe in the future when I buy it I will install a new one. So we are ready, and from the two sides everything connected well. I use it silicone to prevent leakage inside the hardtop. So we are just more or less ready, I would say.
Now we connecting our boom trawler to our hardtop. But unfortunately we have a big problem.
Where I unscrew this bolt is fixing our boom trawler, so it's connected our boom to the arc. And I found, you see, the thread damaged.
When I made holes to just to screw all the bolt of trawler in, one bolt, it's M8, just, you know, fall down. And I understood that we have problem with the thread in the nut, so we have to open this area and to check the threads, because if one with a problem, we could have a problem with the rest. And unfortunately I was right.
So guys, I had to open our hardtop. It looks a little bit scary, but don't worry, this area I will fill with epoxy. It will be even stronger than honeycomb, and all the pressure will be on epoxy. I will add some talc or some other material to make this area stronger, so in terms of this it will be fine. But what I found, thread inside is fine, that absolutely not fine, and this one is just, you know, get down. I have a thread cutter, so I took one size bigger and just made new thread here and here. So we have M8 thread in these two threads, and here and here we have M10. But what I also found, look, you see here the thread, the nut inside looks like made with aluminium. I will double check, but I think it's not just, you know, correct way to have it, because it is a big risk. This is just, you know, area with a huge power, so I have to do something with this. What I also found, look, we have an arc with a little bit angle, so you can see this angle. This one is fine, this one, look, so the angle is different. And if we check this one, look at this. So we have four bolts with absolutely different angles. Maybe at the end, on top, everything will be fine. Maybe when in Beneteau they made it, they make a just to drill it and make thread and put it on top and screw and that's it. So probably it was like this, but I think we need to make it proper way, because this area is very important. Because look at this sail, look at this boom, all the power of sail pushing boat with only this area, and I think we have to make it properly, not like this, of course.
We definitely have to know what inside our arc, how it made. So let's go inside through this hole and check what is inside. And the score.
After our endoscopic investigation, we understood that on top of arc inside it's absolutely flat surface. And if we cut it, we will be able to put inside some metal piece with nuts and screw our blocks with our arc together, and we will have a quite solid construction. On the bottom of our arc we have two technical holes, and we will be able to put inside our enforcers and put it with the messengers, with the lines on top. After we drill it a hole, you can see better what is inside our arc. So the surface is flat. Now we have to put huge amount of silicone between our hardtop and arc. Very important to find silicone with anti-fungi mark, because otherwise we will get a mold in this area. So we are using proper silicone and put it. We use it about 10 bottles of silicone and fill it like with a 1.5 centimeter gap between. You can see we have a perfect results. Small holes after screws we will fix, we will cover it with a gel coat when we put the top layer of gel coat on top of our hardtop holes. To lift up our metal pieces we need to use a messenger, but the problem of the messenger is it's too soft. So firstly we need to put inside the arc something more strong, like electric wire, put it down and pull the rope, pull the messenger all the way up. After, attach our metal piece to the messenger and lift it up through the hole inside our arc. And after, we need to put in a proper position our enforcers, our holes for bolts should match our enforcers. Before using bolts I need to put a heat shrink on it, because when we screw the bolt in and fill the holes with the epoxy, there is a chance not to unscrew our bolt out. But if we use a heat shrink, the chance for it is a minimal, so we just unscrew the bolts and it will work perfectly. To make the structure strong, I added to our epoxy fiberglass and talc. Also, you need to be very careful with the proportion, because if you add less or add more, the structure of epoxy will not be perfect and you could have a problem in the future. So now we just fill our hole with epoxy resin with all the enforcers inside.
Have big fail to look on a hard top. I filled epoxy resin to the holes for enforcement. We have two holes here, and I just put paper towels to protect this area, just epoxy will not go out. And unfortunately, I did that part wrong, and the epoxy start to pass through the paper towels, and look what had happened. We f***ed our tick in a cockpit, so now that every spot is a spot of epoxy resin. Dina already cleaned it with the towels, but we have to solve this problem with the sandpaper and just polish the surface and remove this area with epoxy. And exactly the same sheet we have on our cockpit. So you can see now that all that spot, every spot is was a drop of epoxy resin, and we f***ed our cockpit.
We have to sand it as well, just to make our tick beautiful again. But now you see, it is just, you know, small mistake and so big problem, and just you all your boat. Keep in mind.
now it's a time to install all electronics on our hardtop. So it should be stern light, it should be solar panels, cables, and etc. So it is a quite big amount of wires we need to put through and to drill some holes. After I connected wires to our stern light, I cover all the contacts with liquid tape to protect it from water which can get inside and damage our contacts. Now it's time to connect our solar panels, to connect electrical part and fix our solar panels on top of our hardtop.
So guys, I would like to show you some small trick. Look, we have a perfect surface and top surface, but I need to screw my solar panel to it. So we can drill through and put washer on a bottom and just screw together. I would like to leave my surface without any washers, without any holes. It is very easy to do. Let's go and I'll show you.
First of all, you need to mark a place where you are going to drill a hole, where the bolts should be after all that processes. Now you need to drill a hole big enough to put a nut inside. So you can see, now you can put a nut inside this hole big enough. After, you need to use Allen key to take the honeycomb out. Not all, but small area where you are going to put a nut. After, we have to prepare a mix epoxy with some enforcers. So in this case we use fiberglass, and don't forget about the proper proportion, and mix everything well together. And after, you need to put it inside our hole, but not fill all, because you need to have a space for a nut. After you put a nut, you need to fill all our hole until full. It's a time for solar panels installation. We use it part which is normally people use for solar panels, for big constructions, which solar panels assembled together. And it is quite tricky now, because it should be connected quite close, and it's not really much space around to walk, so I have to be very careful not fall down from a rooftop. But anyway, we assembled together two solar panels. Now we have 1.1 kilowatts of energy. After installation of our solar panels on our hardtop, we have to connect it with proper electrical wires. So be careful, and it is very important to find the proper gauge of your wires. We using a hydraulic clamper to connect two cables together. It is a temporary solution because in the future we are planning to rebuild the system, but now we don't have a full amount of wires we have to use in our system.
Guys, now connection finished. So you see, I made the temporary connectors because I don't have a proper MPPT controller for now. And when I buy three different MPPT controller for all my solar equipment, I will show you how to install it properly. But for now, temporary, I connect two solar panels with a hardtop to my old MPPT controller, which could manage up to 80 amps. So I have a quite powerful MPPT, and these temporary quick connectors, I think, suitable for this task, temporary.
Final step, we are fixing our boom. So we need to put all the lines, all the blocks, and put it in a correct way, because it is our boom trawler, and it should be very strong. Can you imagine the tension of the lines and the pressure on our hardtop? I calculated all the loads before we started this project, and I'm pretty sure everything should be fine without any issues in the future.
Now go to funniest part. I will tell you how much does it cost to build this hardtop, at least in our case.
For labor we paid $3,000. It was a salary for 3 weeks. Initially they promised us to finish this project with this time. Welding, labor and materials, we paid $600. Tools, bolts, wires, etc. We paid $600 per all. Materials. Honestly, we don't know, because our friends cannot calculate it for us. So we thought it should be about from $1,000 to $2,000. Another 1,500 we paid for a telehandler, for marina, for a staying overnight in a technical sleep. So it is a quite big amount of task, and all small tasks should be paid. So we calculate 1,500 for all the services. So the total price is about $8,000. Now, timings. We expected to finish our project with 3 weeks, but in the reality it took us 3 months. It is a Panamanian reality. All the projects could be fast, could be crazy long, so I think our project is something in between.
So guys, this is our beautiful hardtop with the price of regular Sunbrella fabric. Don't forget to subscribe, because in the closest future I will tell you about all electronic connection and how to make your boat independent in terms of electricity, and it means water and blah blah blah. So subscribe to our YouTube channel Captain German Exploring. Don't forget to write comment, and see you in next video. Bye bye.